Hello there, this is Naupnim. In this video I'm going to show you how to make a command clock using the functions in Minecraft 1.13. Therefore I made a simple preset data pack. As you might know, data packs can contain structures and so on, but this data pack is for functions only. Of course you can add new material, but so far it only contains functions. So I'm in the folder of the Minecraft world I'm currently in. It's called 1.13. And here we have a folder called data packs. So go in here, and now I can already see the data pack, the preset data pack. By the way, you can change the name of it. It's important to know which folders you can rename. So this one you can change. Here you cannot change the names of these because otherwise it would break everything. But inside the pack.mcmeta file you can change the description. And in data you have these two folders, Minecraft and preset. You can change again preset, but you are not allowed to change Minecraft because again it would break everything. In preset you have the folder functions, which you can again not rename. And in here you have your functions and subfolders with more functions. And here you can rename everything. Alright, so let's go back to Minecraft, or to data and to Minecraft. And tags, again, you cannot rename this. And you can also not rename this one. And these two names should stay the same as well. And now these two files are very important because they tell Minecraft which functions to run at which event. So load will run preset setup every time the data pack is loaded. For example, when you do /reload, and it will run a function which will then activate the tell raw. Which you can see in here. It's called setup, and here's the tell raw command. So let's go back. That's what load does. And tick will tell Minecraft which function to run every game tick. And that's basically the command clock we need. It's kind of like the ticking command block. I actually forgot the name because I haven't used it in such a long time. Okay, so it's the repeating command block. And yeah, that's basically what the functions will do. They will behave like such a command chain. And the tick function is the one running every game tick. And we can find it in preset, functions, and tick. And if I add this command, say hi, and I do reload, it will say hi 20 times a second. And as you can see, the server, the internal Minecraft server, is executing the command. It's not the player or any other entity. You have to keep that in mind. So let's remove that again. You can also change the setup function, and you can edit the tick function, of course. And as I said, this is the clock, you could say. And yeah, you can also make subfolders. And let's see how that works. Function. This is how you execute functions manually. You could also execute the tick function, but that doesn't really make any sense. And here you can see how subfolders work. So you have the main folder name, the subfolder name, and then the function name. And it's basically a say hi command. And now you can see that I'm the one executing the command because I was running the function. As I said, keep that in mind, that the tick function is run by the server and not by the player. And that's basically it for this video. I hope it helps you to make your own data packs. That's it. See you next time. Bye.